In the year 1913, the enrollment here at St. George's College was barely 100 students. However, there was the urgent need for classroom space. This then led to the authorization and subsequent construction of this iconic building by the headmaster whose name it bears, Father William O'Hare. Now let us fast forward 108 years later, after numerous earthquakes, hurricanes and effects of our rapidly changing climate. This landmark of our beloved college, though appearing as a formidable tower of strength and resilience, is in dire need of our help.
Let us pray. Lord, we give you thanks for the works of your hand, for those persons who labor long and hard for assisting with the building up of your reign here at St. George's College. Today, O Lord, we stand before the O'Hare Building, a hallmark of excellence, your handiwork, a demonstration to our students and stakeholders that with hard work and determination, greatness can be attained. As we continue our Christian journey, may our faith give us the strength we need to withstand the test of our time. As we look forward to the future, we ask for hope that we will come to a greater appreciation of each other and to see the goodness that is around us now in the midst of so much apparent darkness. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son and our brother, that the church say, Amen.
The reading comes from the book of Ephesians, and we are reading from chapter 2, from verse 19 through to the end. Now, therefore, you are no longer strangers and foreigners, but fellow citizens with the saints and members of the household of God. Having been built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone, in whom the whole building, being fitted together, grows into a holy temple in the Lord, in whom you also are being built together for a dwelling place of God in the Spirit. Here ends the reading of the Holy Word of God. Thanks be to God.
This old building, the O'Hare Building, is really a gathering place for many people over the years. As classrooms, it pulled together people from all facets of Jamaican society, different races, social locations, and abilities. In some ways, they came here as strangers and left as brothers, friends, blue blood. As we reflect and become all nostalgic up in our feelings about this building, let us not lose sight of what would animate the formation of this college and the fraternity that existed then and now. That great animator is Jesus Christ. This experience of Jesus Christ will allow others to grow into their purpose and be seen as witnesses of God's love here on earth. Like the building, we all have our imperfections, areas that are in need of repair. In some cases, it is not enough to repair, we have to replace it. In a similar way, parts of our lives are in need of repair. But the presence of imperfection does not take away or mean the absence of God. Like the O'Hare building, we are all impressive edifices, but in need of repair and in some cases renovation. Goodness is still there. May we have the courage to see the goodness in ourselves. May we have the courage to continue to witness to the presence of God in this world as we live our lives in the light of God. Amen.
Good morning, everyone, both to those physically present as well as those viewing virtually. And happy St. George's Week to all Georgians, past and present. As you know, our focus for this year is the O'Hare Building. It's represented in our theme for the week, O'Hare We Are, honoring our past, embracing our present, inspiring our future. The O'Hare Building, which houses our fifth and sixth form classes, as well as offices of the vice principal and the upper school supervisors, is more than just a building of classrooms and offices. If the walls could talk, they would share the memories that many generations have shaped here with their peers, memories that last a lifetime. Yes, we know about the football matches in the rooms, and we also know about the DJ competitions, just to say, that have taken place on the blocks over the years. William Francis O'Hare, S.J., became headmaster of St. George's College in 1908 and served the college for 10 years. During his first term as headmaster on March 3, 1913, ground was broken for the O'Hare Building. The college had outgrown its cramped quarters in the old Pawsey House on the Winchester Park property, purchased from Alfred Pawsey on February 11, 1905. New classrooms were needed urgently. Thus, on March 19, 1913, a contract was signed for the building of the O'Hare Building by old boys Eustace and Clement Fieldings. William O'Hare's wise decision made over 100 years ago still graces us today. The beneficiaries of classes held in the O'Hare Building, under whose shadow we gather this morning, have been many. In 2009, old boy Carl Chang helped us to renovate the flooring of the O'Hare Building, which was termite ridden. Out of the project, he created blocks of wood, 100-year-old wood from the O'Hare Building. With changes in teaching and learning over the years, most especially in this past year, it behooves us to follow in the footsteps of the visionary William O'Hare and update the building to meet the needs of today's students. Our theme for this year's St. George's Week is therefore apt. While honoring this grand structure of the past, we aim to embrace the present by modernizing the resources contained therein, adding technology to the classrooms, and creating other technological spaces so that we can inspire our young knights to innovate for the future. We invite all our partners to work with us on this exciting project, which is slated to last 2 years and end in 2023, when the building will be 110 years old. I feel that William O'Hare would have been smiling and nodding down at us this morning as we embark on this venture to build on the legacy that he has left behind. Journey with us for the next 2 years as together we bring this worthwhile project to fruition.
Greetings, fellow Georgians. Ian Telfer, president of the St. George's College Old Boys Association and class of 1987. The O'Hare Building is rich in history. It's where we spent the last two senior years at St. George's College. It was the years where, as prefects or form prefects, we were charged to mold the minds of the younger Georgians, whether directly or indirectly. It was watching the sun rise over the cathedral at 6:30 in the morning whilst we all chatted on the steps, whether it was Denzel reading his newspaper or Beadle Chung doing his crossword puzzles. Up on the top floor, we had classes. Father Shields comes to mind. He was more than a teacher to us then, he was a friend. Or Key Club socials in the library. As we rallied in the 1980s with our Flyer Flag for George's campaign, which ultimately resulted in the construction of the Abe Issa Auditorium, which has served many generations since then. Again, we call for that rallying cry around the restoration of the O'Hare Building, because as a Georgian family, as a Roman Catholic family, we all understand the significance of this building. And as such, we'll put our hands and hearts together on this venture to ensure that 2 years from now, when the O'Hare Building celebrates 110 years, it will look like the Mecca of St. George's College as it is expected to be. Georgians, I thank you.
Hello, my name is Patrick Williams, president of the St. George's College Old Boys Association of the District of Columbia and graduate of the SDGC class of 1981. As we prepare ourselves for the week of celebrations for the Feast of St. George and St. George's Day on April 23rd, I would like to join with the school to advocate for contributions toward the O'Hare Building Restoration Project. A goal of raising $12 million Jamaican dollars has been set to restore and update the O'Hare Building for completion on September 13th, 2023, when the building will be 110 years old. Not only is the O'Hare Building a cherished icon for us as Georgians, but it is also historically significant to Jamaica. It was in this building that the Jamaica Credit Union League was founded by Jesuits of St. George's and was featured on a stamp issued in 1992 to celebrate the 50th anniversary of the credit union movement in Jamaica. Thank you for any donation that you can make towards this worthy cause.
Hi everyone, I'm Michael Lewis, president of the Florida chapter of the Old Boys Association, and I'm here today to just talk to you and encourage you to participate in the upcoming project to renovate the O'Hare Building. The O'Hare Building is the oldest building on the campus, and it's the central and focal point of St. George's. It's a building that holds great memories, good times for me and for so many of us who walk the halls, the campus of St. George's. But the old lady is in need of some help, and I'm just encouraging all of us to do our part, whatever we can. Every little, you know, as I say, every little make a muckle. So, you know, as much as you can, as little as you can, but do your thing, do your part, contribute so that we can restore the old lady. Thank you.
Happy St. George's Day to you all. I'm Terrence Beach, representing all of the St. George's College Old Boys here in the United Kingdom. And we want to show our support for the O'Hare Restoration Project as we aim to raise 12 million Jamaican. We know how important the O'Hare Building has been, especially in those formative years while we're at St. George's College. And more importantly, we know how key this building will be in the years ahead. So please join us in this very worthy project as we restore this major landmark that has been with us for the better part of 110 years. So, ad majorem, gloriam, for the greater glory of God. Thank you for your continued support and all the very best with celebrating St. George's Week. Thank you.
Hello, fellow Georgians and well-wishers. This is Christopher Chin of the St. George's College Old Boys Association Ontario Chapter inviting you to join us on our journey to restore and redevelop an iconic structure on the St. George's College campus, the O'Hare Building. Thousands of Georgians have passed through its doors and have fond memories of this iconic structure. But it needs our help. Father Time has taken a toll on it, and we now need to restore it to its former glory and redevelop it to make it more meaningful in its purpose for the students of today and in the future. Won't you join us? Give generously, and remember, one cocoa full basket, so give what little you can. It will go a long way to ensuring the future of our young gentlemen and women that pass through its doors. Thank you.
My name is Warren Grant, better known as Bugs, in the class of 1986. I'm also the current president of the St. George's College Old Boys Association of the Northeast. The O'Hare Building has been a very important landmark on the campus of St. George's College. The building has seen better days, and now we believe it's time to not only repair, but also renovate the building. I am appealing to all Knights and friends of the Knights to donate with willing hearts to this worthy cause. Let's return the building to its former glory. Ad majorem Dei Gloria. SDGC.
Be with you.
And
may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
Heard the testimonies and the appeals, and in true Georgian spirit, let us now rally together to ensure that our beloved O'Hare building continues to stand strong for our current and future Georgians. Let us, as men and women for others, give generously to ensure that our grand old banner continues to stream across our beautiful island and across the world. Ad majorem Dei Gloriam, for the greater glory of God.